Hi, I'm Marigold, and I'm a newbie RPG developer Bakin enjoyer, and I want to show you how to use Bakin's free-to-use base sprites that you can put in your game. Okay, so what am I talking about? Basically, RPG developer Bakin is a video game maker engine that allows you to make your own video games, and it comes with a bunch of free-to-use resources like these you're seeing on the screen right now. These are bases that can be edited to be any character you can dream of, without too much hassle. Let me show you how. So, this video is going to be divided into two main parts. The first is obtaining the bases for you to edit and how I go about editing them. And the second is how to upload them into Bakin, so you can use them for your game. And at the end, a little bit of a final thoughts section. Also, you probably heard it by now, but there is a rooster and several chickens in the recording of this video. You will hear them throughout. I am very sorry. So, let's get started. It is a bit of a process to actually get the images from the scene page, and I'll be explaining it in a bit. But for convenience, I've set up a Google Drive link with the images already extracted in the description below. So if you've already obtained them from the link, feel free to skip to this part of the video. To obtain your bases, head over to Bakin's workshop on Steam and look for 2D cast figure sets and click subscribe. After that, you're gonna wanna open RPG Bakin and then head over to Steam Workshop panel under the top menu. You'll see your 2D cast figure sets right here. Click on it and press rename and save project. You can put this anywhere you want. It'll show up as a zip folder. All you have to do is extract that. Then it will show up as an .exrbr file. Then head over back to Bakin. Click on any game that you're currently working on. Open up your resources. Click on 2D stamps, add, local files, and then add in your file that you just extracted. Here it'll add in all of the figures that you're gonna be editing. And there they are. These little guys are ready to be edited. After that, you head over to images, select your figures, and then take them out of Bakin. Add them to the folder you want them to be in. And there you go, you have all your textures ready to go. To edit these images, I'll be using a sprite, but you can use whatever you like. It's up to you. Okay, just so it doesn't feel like this image, here are some tips for the drawing part. The first is to have your character reference ready and study the already existing sprites that are available. They are so good. Oh my god. The second, hotkeys, baby! Take the time to learn or edit them. They will save you so much time in the long run. And that leads me to my third tip. This one is a bit of a personal preference, but I like starting with the walk cycle base. Just because it's really useful to copy and paste the pieces that you've already made into other sprite bases like the running or the weight or the standstill kind of ones. So it's really easy to accommodate for the different animations. And we're done. Here's what we ended up with. I made the jump animation for this video, but I also made a walk and a run animation. Once you're done editing your images, you're gonna add it into Bakin by pressing add, then finding your file, adding it in. Then here, you're gonna make sure that your settings are good. So sRGB, yes, that's a color setting. Clamp, 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 and then nearest, and nearest, and then we're gonna slice it. Slicing is basically your animation. So here I have 4 frames. I'm going to put count slimes? There's only... you have your X and Y axis, so I only have one on the X, and then there's four on the Y. There you go. Now you see those little lines, so that means it's correctly divided, each of these little boxes. Usually you have to worry about size and your dimensions and that. But since you're using the bases, it's all kind of pre-made for you, which is the best part. I already have a model of my character walking, so all I have to do here is add the motion. Add the jump. Now it'll show up with this cool action pose here. However, it's not gonna work properly because, as you can see, I have my walk animation, my wait animation, but here the names are different, so it won't pick up. All you have to do is head over to your motion name and change it. Ta-da! You're done! Yay! Now you can grab your character and take it for a whirl. You know, walk it around, do fun little spins, and get all excited. You did it! Hi again! I hope you found this tutorial useful, even if just a little bit. This video was made for the Bakin Tutorial Jam, hosted by Ash. And I actually wanted to participate before in a different game jam, but I realized I was too much of an idiot and I couldn't actually figure out Bakin, but I decided to give it a shot this time. I'm more of an artist than a game dev, but I really enjoy Bakin because I can try a little bit and explore a little more with video games, which I've always wanted to make. If you see this video and know Bakin, please make tutorials, I'm begging you. I'm so stupid, please. There are so many things people are able to do somehow, and I've seen a couple of videos from different developers, and it's just kind of insane. Good job, you guys. Please teach me. Help. Thank you. I also wanted to make a separate video, showing how to make some pixel art animations. And talking more about the art side, which is what I'm more familiar with. But it's not really a Bakin tutorial per se, so maybe next time. Once that's all done, you're ready to... something, I don't know.